Hi guys, my name is Paul Ford. I'm the Digital Marketing Manager here at WebTegrity, and I wanted to thank you for joining me for today's Digital Marketing Minute. This is a segment where I'd like to spend a little bit of time going over some of the tools and techniques that you can use for your business or for your clients to help enhance the character that you're adding to the website using different tools and methods that I think will be very helpful. So today, I'm going to share my screen here real quick so we can see. We're going to actually be using Google Analytics and setting up some custom dashboards. One of the things I hear all the time from users is how difficult Google Analytics can be to understand all of the different reports that are within these different menu items. You have to know a lot of terms and spend a lot of time just trying to figure out what these reports are trying to say. So one of the shortcuts that I use for a lot of our clients is under this customization tab here at the top left-hand menu. What the customization tab does is it allows you to build these custom dashboards for users within your Google Analytics account or for clients that you can export, you can share with your boss, you can share with your marketing manager. It makes you really look cool, like a genius when it comes to Google Analytics, even without knowing a whole ton about the platform. And so you can see here, there's a couple of different options once you click into dashboards. And now we've created a few of these dashboards that we'll click into and take a look at. But the very basics is you could just basically click on this big red create button. You're going to be given an option to either start with a blank canvas or start with a starter dashboard. You can name it whatever you'd like. In this case, we're going to go ahead and start with a starter dashboard just to show you what that looks like. And you're going to click on that and hit create dashboard. And then what you get is kind of a templated basic dashboard with these different widgets. The kind of way that you use this, you can click and drag the widgets, place them wherever you'd like. You can customize each one. You can customize the look and feel. Each Google Analytics view can have up to 20 dashboards, and each dashboard can have up to 12 widgets built within it. The nice thing about it is that you can kind of combine the reports here. If you want to look at something like your audience acquisition and behavior reports kind of at a snapshot, custom dashboards are a great way to do that. Up here at the top, you can select your date range. And then something I really like to do is build a comparison report between two periods. So say you want to look at this dashboard that has our users, new users, sessions by browser, sessions by location, bounce rate, goal completions. And then you want to compare it to the previous period. All you have to do, just like with any Google Analytics dashboard, is click compare to previous period. All fully customizable, really cool and easy to do. And then there you go, you've got an overlay of blue and orange. The only thing you have to be kind of careful of course, is that this gets a little cluttered depending on the time and space and the different types of reports that you put on there, but you can see that it overlays one on top of the other. So then let's look at some of the ones that I've created here. We're gonna basically first go look at something I've named the WebTegrity Dashboard. What this is a very quick snapshot of what we're looking at. I'm going to remove the comparison for now just to remove some of the clutter. But basically what this does is it gives me a real quick snapshot that I can export, share with anybody. We can kind of compare different periods, see how we're doing. And I've added these things are kind of the important metrics to measure how our website is doing just in kind of an overall basis. So we've got users and bounce rate by source and medium, organic searches, our goal completions, average session duration and pages per session. Locations, top landing pages, things of that nature. So then once you get in here, you can click on the little pencil icon on any of the widgets, and that allows you to edit the widget. And so if we wanted to change our widget, we could name it something different. You could name, or you could create the different type. If we wanted to be a bar graph, for example, instead of a timeline, we can do that. It's fully customizable. You can select whatever you want to on here. And all you have to do is just click save. In this case, we're not going to be able to do it because I didn't fully build it. But it allows you to kind of customize what you want to see and what's most important to you. One of the cool things about it as well is within any of these widgets, you can link it to a report in your Google Analytics. So opening up the users widget here, you can see the difference is there's black text versus blue linkable text. And once you open this up, you can hit link to report or URL and just start typing. So in this case, we're going to type users, and we can show it that we would like this to go to our users flow report. So now when we click save, you can see that text changed to blue and you can click on it and it brings you directly to the report within Google Analytics so that you can learn more about that particular item. Going back to our customization and dashboards, we're gonna look at a couple of the other ones that I've built here. So this one is something really cool, built as an SEO dashboard. So if when I click into that, you can see that there's a couple of widgets that have been created for keywords, our SEO visitors or organic visitors, the search engines used to find it, and the pages viewed by SEO, cities finding us through SEO, and then local keywords based on where we're located, which is San Antonio, Texas. And again, you can click into any of these and you can edit them. In this case, for example, what we see is that I've put in a couple of conditional logic statements for only show the metro areas containing San Antonio, don't show any keywords that are not set or not provided. And then this one, we put in our brand name, Webtegrity. So we wanna show keywords, in this case, showing our brand name. And so then you can see there it went, it narrowed down. You could do that for any of these, and you can link them to any report that you'd like to in Google Analytics. So then here's the best part. This is the part that makes you look like a genius. See this button right here, it says export. You can click on it, you can export as a PDF, or you can set up email alerts to go to anybody that you want to that has access to your Google Analytics account, and you can set a frequency. You can send it just the one time today, or you can set this report to mail out weekly or monthly or quarterly, however often that you like. And then even better than that, you can share a link. So if you manage multiple clients or if you have multiple businesses with different analytics accounts, you hit this share template link, and that's gonna give you a link you can share with anybody. It does not share your data, but it does share the way that you have your dashboard set up. And so you can recreate this dashboard on multiple websites for clients or for multiple businesses. And then you can select the view that you'd like it to go to. They also have this solutions gallery. So let me show you this here. The Google Analytics Solutions Gallery. You find that, by the way, by clicking here on Share and Solutions Gallery, or just by looking it up. But the Solutions Gallery is a really cool tool that you can go in and you can find all these tons and tons of dashboard templates that have been built by all kinds of different Google users. And so you can click kind of on any of them and it'll give you an example of what it looks like, a description, you get a rating. It's almost like downloading apps or something like that. You get a lot of social value in this where people are sharing it. You get to see how many people are using it. And it gives you a really cool starting point for templates that you can use within these dashboards. So you don't really have to create everything from scratch. Last thing I'll show you here is something really fun, Ad Segment. That allows you to kind of either build from scratch or select custom segments within your Google Analytics account so that you can add another layered dimension to your dashboard reports, similar to what we did earlier by selecting the date and comparing it to a previous period. So in this case, the segment, we're in the SEO dashboard. Let's actually switch over and let's look at a dashboard, the geography dashboard, which is kind of cool. One that I've got broken down by state, continent, by city, and it actually has kind of a page speed thing built in by city. So you can see like these certain cities around the world, the website loads slower there, kind of give you some insight on whether or not you're having some issues with exits based on that. And then let's add a segment. And let's go ahead and select this segment down here called organic traffic. Organic traffic, of course, are users that have found us based on searches in a search engine. And you can see that that segment breaks down. It shows us 81.84% of the sessions within this time period were organic. And then you can see it edits our widgets here. So now we have a comparison between all of our users versus organic users. This is really useful if you're trying to break into segments based on your paid ROI versus organic ROI. This is a good way to see whether or not your organic SEO efforts are paying off because you can compare it. By period, you can compare it by place, you can compare it by performance. And so you can look down and you can see here, all users within this city of San Antonio where we're located, we had in this period 1,719 sessions. And you can see organic, 991 of those sessions were attributed to organic traffic. And you can do that for any dashboard that you build in here. So we can go back over to our main Webtegrity dashboard and that segment should still be in place. And then we can see a comparison in orange versus blue. Where does organic traffic come from versus our all users? Really cool way to do it. I've only barely touched base. I'm going to add a couple of these links down to the description box below this video. As always, if you have questions about anything, concerns, need any help, just shoot us a comment down here on YouTube. We'll be very happy to jump on there and answer any of your questions. I hope this helped you out today for today's Digital Marketing Minute. Again, I'm Paul Ford. Thanks again for watching, and you guys have a wonderful day.